Shopify strongly believes that virtual reality and augmented reality will fundamentally shift how we shop in the future.
A lot of people, when they think of AR and VR, they think of games, they think of maybe learning stuff. No one ever really thinks of commerce when they think VR.
It allows you to kind of look at objects at the proper scale and to put them in a context where they'd actually be used. And it's also a new way for brands to tell stories about the things they sell.
So Shopify chose to go with Unreal Engine because of the fact that it's so easy to get up and started. And we know that the editor is easy enough to use for our artists, it's great for our developers, and it allows us to build these prototypes really quickly. One of the first experiments we did was something called Thread Studio, and it was a tool to visualize what a t-shirt would look like. You could go in there and very intuitively you could move around these graphics and see it on these mannequins, and it would actually look like it would in real life.
One of the things we found that people had a lot of fun interacting with were the mannequins. Posing them in silly positions, putting googly eyes on these mannequins, and that became a real feature of the app.
Would it help you visualize the shirt any better? Maybe not. Was it fun? Of course it was. Following Thread Studio, we realized we need a tool to be able to iterate way faster. And that's why we built Expo on top of Unreal Engine. That would be this collaborative brainstorming tool where we could try out these interactions right there in VR.
Brainstorming in VR makes sense when you're thinking about how we can make VR usable and better.
The thing that was making all of this possible was Unreal Engine's fantastic network capability. Whether people are on VR, some people are on iPads using AR, other people are just on their laptops, and it's all just running seamlessly. Honestly, we would have been terrified if we had to write network code from scratch.
Merging AR and VR together it was very much something we stumbled across trying to do something else. Once it happened and once it was working, everyone was just like, oh my goodness, this is like a game changer.
Let's say you're at home and you're using AR to be able to preview furniture in your house, but maybe you need some help from an interior designer. Well, that interior designer could be anywhere else in the world in a virtual reality headset, and they'll just magically teleport their avatar into your space. They'll be able to see your room and help you pick that right item. You're getting this very personal shopping experience, you know, delivered from your living room.
A lot of people think that Shopify got into VR too early for this type of company. We think it's actually going to creep up on people. New devices are going to come out and things are going to change really quickly. And Unreal has been great about keeping up with all the innovations that are happening in the AR and VR space.
It feels like Christmas every like 2 months. Features that were like, oh, it would be really nice if Unreal had this. It's like, yeah, next version, they just have it. It's like they're reading our minds, which is amazing. This VR thing is new. So it's a lot of throwing stuff at the wall and seeing what sticks and doing these wacky experiments, because we have to just discover all the gems that this medium brings.